public planning meeting. That way you can determine if it's too watery or something. This does seem, it might be a little thin, but sometimes I like it a little bit thinner. Doesn't take a lot. Don't lob a bunch of slurry on there because when you print, it'll create a mess. And you want to choose a squeegee that is the right width for your image. And see how I just use that a little bit? I pick it up right on my squeegee. So when I lift the screen up, that's not going to run down the screen. So that's not bad. Not bad at all. Could probably make it a hair thicker.
Going back and run the second half, you swipe it once.
Now, the reason I haven't pinched is because I will go back more than once. But for the first ones, just for the test to see if it prints well, I'm just testing to see. I'm on the plastic that I have attached to this hinge board. Now, here's one thing that I did that normally I wouldn't do, is let that set and dry, because once that material dries in the void, you're not going to be able to print that image very easily. So normally, if I know I'm going to be doing something else, I clean the screen right away. So again, see how I'm picking that up on the squeegee? You don't want to leave a bunch that's going to run all the way down. So because I let that dry, I didn't get as nice of a print as I thought I would get. So all you have to do is clean the screen. And when I do this, I don't take it off and wash it because I want to keep the image where it's at. Right.
Why are you putting it on acetate?
Because that helps me line up the image later. It's just another tool.
So the screen is always lined up.
Yeah, it is. What can happen is say, what's your name?
Ashley.
Say Ashley was just like, "Hey, Brian, how you doing?" and bumped your thing.
Yeah, that happens. I've seen that. Yeah. Then you have to realign it.
Then you have to realign it. Yeah, exactly.
I see.
Actually,
what's
it doing?
Yeah.
Take care of it. And sometimes I've also found that if you wash the screen a little bit first, like I'm doing here, and there's a little bit of moisture in the mesh, it allows that material to pass through a little bit easier. And you can use a rubber clay grip for this. It doesn't have to be screen print. A tip on cleaning the screen. Just a sponge from this side first. do that a couple times, and then clean the back side. You don't have to take it off and wash it.
That I would love myself.
Add to the texture and depth. But it also helps me take advantage of this material that is clay. Otherwise, why do it on clay? I can be doing this on paper. But part of the reason I'm a clay artist is I like the way it moves. I like to be able to cut it. I like to be able to draw into it. I like to be able to put grooves in it. And so these kinds of things you'll notice that I have these like shaped like an L here. I do that so I can push my board all the way into that corner. That will help keep Ashley from bumping into it. it'll keep me from moving. So when I paint this on, I'm not just going to do one big part. What I'm trying to do is hit it where it looks like they're standing on some grass or pink or whatever that is. That and I use this as a guide. You know, I can't lay it all the way down on there because it'll stick to it. Let's just use as a guide. And then I'm going to add a little bit of cinnamon to change it up a little bit, you know, so it's not just all pink.
Is there a reason to use the black slip instead of the black underglaze?
I have control over the ceramic properties in terms of like fusion and certain temperatures and stuff. Where the underglaze, you just kind of, you have what you have. If this particular underglaze, if you fire it high enough, like cone 10, it'll start to get a slight gold. So in that way, you can really capitalize on ceramic effects. Then I'll set upon painting in the little guys.
Oh, okay.